Protectors of the Sunnah. Sunnah Baba. Protector of the Sunnah.
ونستعين ونستغفر. نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء. واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، خير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، فإن كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Before I start my khutbah, I will request my dear respected brothers to move forward as much as they can, please. And do it for the sake of Allah, not because I'm doing it. I'm saying do it, please. I know some of you do not like somebody to tell them what to do. But wherever you go someplace, somebody telling you what you're supposed to do. Now, I go secondly to those brothers who are sitting in the reception area. I'm asking you kindly that you move from your spot and practice the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. That means come to the musalla and get closer. The Prophet ﷺ warned us against this, and I keep saying it every Jum'ah, but it seems we hear from here and take it from here to most of us. ولا يزال أناس يتأخرون حتى يؤخرهم الله. People keep it. Subhanallah, not even one single move from the reception room. Why? Why Muslims? Why a Muslim could not tell the Muslim do something and they do it? Why? I know I'm not your father. I know I'm not your under anything to you. I'm asking you to practice the sunnah of the Prophet. I'm asking you to save your life for the sake of Allah. The more that you go distant, the more that Allah will kick you out. This is what the Prophet saying. People keep delaying themselves and going farther away, away, until Allah put them away. Why you do this to yourself? Once a week we could not do it right? Is it too much? Inshallah, kindly, hopefully, that next week we ask those upstairs, down, come down the stairs. But our khutbah today about getting our degree, getting our certificate, getting your diploma, getting whatever that you want to call it in English or French or in Spanish. Most of us, if you look to the people who are sitting, maybe 70% or 75% of the people sitting are from different countries. If you ask any one of them, what are you doing in America? Why did you come here? Basically, you're going to find a close answer. Came for a job, opportunity, came for a degree, came to get a citizenship, okay? I'm not going to touch this subject now. But for every one of us, we have a goal in this life. And we try to reach to this goal regardless. You come by aeroplane, in a ship, somebody sneak you in the car, in the back with the luggage, doesn't matter. You want to go to Jannah, the dunya Jannah. So go to America. But regardless wherever you are, what color you are, what country from, there is a goal for you. You try to achieve it. What actually we try to achieve? Doesn't matter if you're in Arabia, or you are in America, or you are in Russia. All this, what you want to talk about, bachelor degree, master degree, PhD degree, postdoctor degree, or I want to be a doctor, I want to be a physician, I want. This is temporary. It's temporary goal. When you dropped it, you could not do anything with this piece of paper. How many years did you spend for to get this piece of paper, this certificate, to call you doctor so and so? Doesn't matter if you are a doctor, as a physician, or in chemistry, or whatever it is. You want this. But your Creator, Almighty Allah, had put a goal and certificate for you. And I want to tell myself before anybody else, if we leave this life and we did not reach this goal, we are losers. What it is certificate you're talking about? The name of it is Abdullah or Amadullah. It doesn't matter you're black, you're white, you're male, female, you're educated, you're uneducated. Everyone who testified to La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, he will be in a big trouble if he leaves this life. And we don't know when we leave it. So we need to work hard, get our certificate before we depart. Your age, your youth, your wealth, nothing will prevail and stop. Malakul maut will come and take your soul, and this will be the end of it. I'm asking you, how many years took you to get your master? Forget about PhD degree. Let's talk about small things that all, most of us have it. Rather, this was the elementary school, and this was the middle school, and high school, and a college, and you're talking about you put, make investment of 20, 30 years of your life to get this piece of paper. And guess what? You may found a work after this or not. You may get your citizenship or not. You may, and I'm telling you, I'm older than any one of you sitting here in age, except two or three people. It's reality. All this investment to get this piece of paper, and after he cut it, how much? Brother, it's 25,000. Ooh. But how did you borrow this money? Brother, I borrowed from the bank. So that you took all means, doesn't matter if it's halal or haram, to finish your degree. What is the purpose of us in this life? What is the degree that we want to get out of when we leave this life, which most of us forgotten it? Because we, قُلْ أَتُعَلِمُونَ اللَّهَ بِدِينِكُمْ, say, O Muhammad, to them, do you teach Allah about your deen? We are not going to tell Allah. Allah tells us. So you got in haram usury alone, and you spent 30 years, and you got your master's degree, and after this you reached America, and after this, after three interviews, and you got a lawyer, and all these things, you've not even got a green card, and now you don't know what to do with this piece of paper. What degree Before the khutbah finished, and this brother did not tell me what this. Listen, very simple. وإنه ليسير على من يسره الله عليه. وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون. ما أريد منهم الرزق وما أريد أن يطعمون. إن الله هو الرزاق ذو القوة المتين. Almighty Allah is saying what the meaning is, I did not create mankind or jinn. And you know jinn may be more smarter than you, at least is powerful than you. It flies. Jinn flies. You could not fly. You have to go in every flight. But jinn can go like this. So Allah says that He created jinn. He's more sophisticated than you, powerful than you, and God for only one single purpose called ibadah. Debasing yourself, surrendering yourself, submit yourself to Allah your creator. That means He tells you right, you go right. He said to you sit down, you sit down. He said to you walk, He said run, you go run. This was ibadah. If you want to know what's ibadah, that means you became abd, you became a slave. When your master said to you, right means right, and there is no second teeth. When he said to you, sit down, you got sit down. Did we get this degree? Do you think by coming to Friday, all the best among us, we make 5-time prayers, of course, 7 minutes from 4 rak'at, now we got this degree, we became Abdullah, and Amatullah, you're kidding. You're fooling yourself. Wake up. Wake up before it's too late. Al-Sha'air, the prayer. They have been summoned the charity box in Jum'ah. And after this, every day, 8 hours working, plus 45 minutes go to the job and 45 minutes come from the job. And so, are you Abdullah or Abdul Dunya? Are you Abdullah or you Abdul Wazifa? Are you Abdullah or Abdul the woman? What are you Abd? That means you could not even step out the door without your master telling you step out. You ask his permission first. And you be afraid to ask because you are nothing but a slave. الَّذِي خَلَقَكَ فَسَوَّاكَ فَعَدَلَكَ فِي أَيِّ سُورَةٍ مَا شَاءَ رَكَّبَكَ. He did everything for you. You own you. He's saying, I created mankind and jinn only for purpose of serving me. Obeying me. Submitting themselves to me. So you think he understands this is a part-time job? Because I went to Jum'ah now, I'm a Muslim. I'm going to Jannah. I'm going to be there sitting beside the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You're kidding yourself. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he's a prophet of Allah. He stood up in night prayer, crying and weeping. حتى بل لحيدا. The prophet. And Allah said that He forgave his past sin and his future sin. And he's standing up in prayer at night, crying and weeping from the fear of Allah. He stood up, not in Jum'ah prayer or Isha prayer, he stood up in Tahajjud, optional prayer, حتى تورمت قدماه. What are you doing, Muslims? What are you doing? Serious. Ask yourself. You think this by coming to Jum'ah? You go to your seat 5 times, 6 times, 7 times. And you may go even sometimes at night. Additional to 6 hours during the day. Because this is the real form of ubudiyyah, when everything that somebody tell you jump, you jump. And you got to be ready to jump before even they tell you jump. Because You know how important this piece of paper, this title. So became Abdul Dollar, Abdul Dirham, Abdul Dinar, anything like this, you're going to jump. The Prophet said, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Ta'isa Abdul Dinar, Ta'isa Abdul Dirham, Ta'isa Abdul Khamisa, Ta'isa Wantakas, Wa in the Sheikh of Al Antashat. Oh, I don't know to make it up. The Prophet says that there is somebody who is the slave of the gold. And somebody else is the slave of the silver. And there is others are the slave of the fashion and the suit that to wear. The Prophet made dua against them, say, Ta'isa wa ta'is. He may be a loser. Do you know what is ubiyya, abudiyya? Do you know what does it mean to make yourself available to Allah at any time? We are not talking about making Jum'ah. We are not talking about somebody by we make janazah. We are not talking when somebody getting married, we're going to celebrate there and they say, bye-bye. We need to wake up. We need to wake up. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, I created you. But Allah, I have children. I have a wife. I have to feed them. I. ما أريد منهم من رزق وما أريد أن يطعمون إن الله هو إن الله الرزاق ذو القوة المتين. You do your part, Allah will do his part. But Allah said, do your part first. He said, وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَمَا تُوَعَدُونَ. That your provision, which one is easier for you, to go to the store, to food line and buy things? Allah said, in the sama, which is that we could not reach to it. He said, don't worry about it. I got it. You be to me what I want, I be for you. I be there for your needs and your want. So you think you understand who can cheat Allah? Give him Jum'ah prayer, and somebody sitting here, and somebody taking, you understand, a nap, and somebody come, you understand, 10 minutes before, and they say, this is our life. This is the reason there is no change in the Muslim's life. They're losing their property, their mind, their brain, their land, everything. You don't have to worry about kuffar. Even from so-called Muslims became your enemy. And tell you what to live, what to do, what it is. When we really can trust Allah, when really we can know that we do what Allah said, He will do what He said. Allah say, وَمَنْ أَصْدَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ قِيلًا وَمَنْ أَصْدَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ حَدِيثًا. Who's better in speech than Allah? Who's more truthful in His promise more than Allah? Otherwise, we're reading words we don't understand. Allah promise you. Allah promise you. He say, I am, not the degree, I am the quwwati zul arshi. He gives you the quwwa and the power and the magnificent throne. He got it all. Why are you running away from him? How many people they open the shop and there's nobody coming? How many people got their degrees, they could not find a job? How many people they spent all the money and they did not get a green card? Is everything in his hand? Be there for Allah. My brothers and sisters, we know we need to change something today. At least here, understanding. Ibadah. كل ما أمر به الله تبارك وتعالى من الأفعال والأقوال ما يحبه الله تبارك وتعالى. Anything that Allah loves, anything that Allah orders, by doing it, you make an ibadah. To such a degree, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, listen, Muslim, saying what? Because most of you misunderstand me. I know it's my problem. My English is not good enough for you. He says, the Imam said, don't go to school. The Prophet is saying what? وَفِي ضِبْعِ أَحَدُكُمْ صَدَقَةً. One of you have intimate relationship with his wife, and it will be recorded in charity for him. So, look to the Islam, look to the beauty. He's not telling you don't have a wife. He didn't tell you you don't have a car. But don't make your car and your degree to be your main goal. To such a degree, you combine in Zuhr and Asr together. Brother, I could not leave the cashier, man. You know, this is the, every people, they can steal the store. So what? Standing. But not standing for Allah. But when it comes standing for Salah, scratching. Everything is itching. We understand? But standing in front of the cashier for 8 hours a day. What kind of a slavery? Ta'is Abdul Dirham. Ta'is Abdul Dirham is no way you're going to succeed. Because you became Abd, slave. Enslave yourself. You enslave yourself. You did it. Priority. Islam did not say leave the school, but Islam said, بَلْ تُؤْثِرُونَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا. This is the problem. This is the way that we are not supposed to go about. To prefer about what man said over what Allah said. To bring the degree, the school, doesn't matter. I can miss a Jum'ah, I can miss Ramadan, I can miss anything. Doesn't matter. But for me to miss one class, and the doctor said to me, this is twice after this, you could not come to my class. Ooh. We come Muslims. Stop fearing gods. There is no gods. There is only one God, Almighty Allah, the creator of all things. Don't fear people more than fearing Allah. Do you think we people building mosques, massage, big mosques, and after this for what? For 3, 5, 7 people to come to make asr. Where is a Muslim? Oh, school. Okay, we understand this school. What about Maghrib? 5 people. What about Isha? 12 people. Where is a Muslim? Basically. Yes. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Does not mean he say إِلَّا لِيَسْجُدُونَ. Only to make salah? No, ibadah. Anything Allah recommended in the Quran or the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this is ibadah. Anything that Allah forbid in the Quran or His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam forbid it, this leave it is ibadah. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying that even by sleeping with your wife with a good intention will be ibadah and will be a charity for you. Come on, my brothers. Come on, my sisters, let's try to struggle and to get our degree to be Abdullah. Abdullah, Amatullah. Not the Abd and the slave of the dollar, the silver, the gold, the job. This is your ilah. Tafza' ilayhi. You feel that all solution will be with the dollar, with the degree. فوالله لو توكلتم على الله حق توكله لرزقكم كما يرزق الطير تغدو خماصا وتعود بطانا. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, by Allah, if you trust Allah, the real trust, He will provide for you like He provide for the birds. Oh brother, this, you don't know the bird that has a master degree? No, you don't. The bird, they trust in Allah. Do we have trust in Allah? So why you can Zuhr and Asr together? Why you could not come to Jum'ah 5 minutes before the Imam started khutbah? Because dunya, dunya, dunya. Now do you know who's your ilah? Now do you know who's your deity? Now do you know? So Allah telling you to do say what? Allahu Akbar is adhan. And you go in salah and say Allahu Akbar. He did not say Allahu Kabir. Akbar, there is nothing greater than Allah, but lip surface is not going to fly. Let your action show that Allah is Akbar in your life and advance the order of Allah before anybody else. Anybody else. Allah comes first. And if you are not going to put Allah first, you're never going to be happy. لا لو كان ابن آدم وديان من ذهب لابتغى ثالثهما ولا يملأ جوف ابن آدم إلا تراب. The son of Adam have two valleys. Two valleys full with what? Nickels, dimes, gold. Full with gold. Full with gold. He always going to say what? Let me buy the other house. Let me buy the other car. Let me never go. ولا يملأ جوف ابن آدم إلا تراب. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah give us the ability to return to real understanding of the deen and live the deen, not to deen. Ameen. Wa akhir da'wan. Alhamdulillah. Rabbil alameen. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله رب العالمين. أصلي وأسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين. الله سبحانه وتعالى إسين أفرأيت من اتخذ إلهه هواه وأضله الله على علم. Our problems that we make our desire, our understanding, our logic another إله beside Allah. So Allah سبحانه وتعالى إسين He has knowledge, but because he prefers something, advanced something over the book of Allah, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make him go and be misguided. And in actuality, Allah telling you that there is a people making aliha from other and your desire. Brother, this doesn't make sense, brother. We in America, brother, you want to... Brother, we want the American people to laugh at us and see. They want to be scared from your beard. Can you make it smaller? It's too much, brother. You understand? What are you working with? Subhanallah. Your desire. Your desire. Don't worry about anybody. Don't worry about it. Worry about Allah. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ This your degree. This your goal. How to debase yourself to be ready to go with the order of Allah and everything else can wait. Let Allah come the first in your life. One last thing that I'd like to end with it. For anybody, inshallah, not to misunderstand me, because I get to be misunderstood many, many, many times by many, many, many people. Anything you do it to please Allah, according the way of Allah or the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is ibadah. Observe with the right intention. Okay? Allah is saying, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي This it? This all what you got? No suki? This it? I'm going to make Umrah and Hajj. I'm up a fucker Siddiq now. Salati wa no suki. What else is it? Wa mahiyaya. My daily life. Your whole program in this life, it has to be what? Not only your life and your death. Why I'm living and why I'm going to die if I'm going to go and die. لله رب العالمين لا شريك له لا شريك له We have to understand everything in your life as a Muslim it can be turned to be a form of ibadah when you do it for pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you do it according to the way of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Why Muslim did not achieve success until today as individual, families, communities, nationwide, everything, because they have Allah in the masajid. And they said, other than this, everything, the Congress, the whatever committee, everybody legislator. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, does he have any gods beside Allah? شَرَعَ لَهُمْ مِنَ الدِّينِ مَا لَمْ يَأْذَنْ بِهِ اللَّهِ We have to turn our life to Allah. In the mosque, out of the mosque, go to the bathroom, being with your wife, being in your store. If you do not do this, wash your hand from happiness and good life in this life. Work hard for your certificate called Abdullah. Struggle not to be Dr. So-and-so. Struggle to be Abdullah. How I can be Abdullah and Amatullah? This is your goal until you die, inshallah. I beg Allah's forgiveness for me and you and all the Muslims. I beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring us to the real deen. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us that we practice and put this deen in action in everything. Ameen. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.